Oh, hello everyone.
Ow, stop.
Hello everyone and welcome to Royal Gaming Battalions. Welcome to
Residual. Sorry,
welcome
go ahead, Joey.
Royal Gaming Battalion's acapella cover of Route 1 from Pokemon Yellow, also known as Let's Play Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. My name is Joey, also known as Ash Ketchum, and today I'm joined by...
Professor Oak! Hello, everybody!
Are you a boy or a girl?
Are you a boy or a girl? I'm gender fluid. Thank you. I'm not really. I'm Jack.
And I'm Misty, also known as Electric.
It's electric. It's electric.
Oh.
I'm surprised you didn't get that the first time.
Well, I think you're referencing the hustle.
Oh. I thought that song was called the Electric Slide.
No, it's called the...
The Hustle? Oh, do the hustle.
Yes, I got it.
You guys ever...
It took me 20 years to learn that's what that was called.
Really?
Yeah.
You guys ever heard the Casper slide?
Slide to the left.
Slide to the right. Reverse.
Everybody clap your hands. Yeah, I hate that song.
Do you really? I love that song.
I had to, like, dance to that in high school, like, in junior high.
Oh. When I was a kid, my mom and I used to go to the roller rink in Fountain Valley, and the one next
to Boomers?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We would go to that all the time on my Saturdays, and, like, on our Saturday afternoons. It was, like, a great way to spend time with her. And that was, like, one of our favorite songs that came up, that and the hamster dance.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, every time I play those two songs, she's like, I love those days. Mm-hmm. She wants us to go to those places. Like, she wants us to go to, like, the Fountain Valley skating rink.
Yeah, I don't know if I could do a skating rink.
Yeah.
Never really skated before.
You know what I'd like to try? I would like to try ice skating again. I've only done it once.
Same here.
Yeah, I really was terrible at it, but at the same time, I liked it, because it's just a really interesting feel.
It's cheese
like
rolling down a hill.
I'm just worried I'm going to roll my ankles in those boots, because I don't like that they're very stiff.
Oh, ice skates?
Because they put starch in like the heel area, and it's really painful.
Yeah, you got to have your own ice skates, because I've been kind of aware of.
Yeah.
This is going to be a bit of a run.
Which is unfortunate, because ice skates are expensive.
Well, one of my ex-girlfriends, like, my first ex-girlfriend, actually, when we were together, took me to an ice skating rink that was near her house.
Mm-hmm.
That, like, they did it seasonally, like, from, like, November to the end of January or something.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, you could go to this outdoor place that they set up to be a ice skating rink. And it was actually really fun. And it was my first time ever doing ice skating.
Mm-hmm.
But, I just remember it being really fun. But, like, she had never skated before either, so it was something we both had never done well.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
I'm the bad guys.
But, like, if we don't do a roller skating rink, we should definitely do an escape room, like I was saying the last episode.
Yeah.
We just get a whole group of people and, like, you know what we should do? We should make it themed or something. Like, dress up as, like characters from some of our favorite, like, movies or TV shows or something. And, like, all of our favorite, like, pop culture characters try to solve the mystery of the room. Like, I always wanted to do a Doctor Who-themed escape room party kind of deal. I wanted to do that 2 years ago for my birthday, but it never came together well.
Mm-hmm.
Like everyone that I, like, set... You had to have, like, a set number of people to go.
Yeah, I remember you wanted to do that.
And, like, half the people who said they were able to go suddenly said that, like, shit came up and they couldn't. So I was like, you know what? I'm canceling this event.
You know,
And then everybody after that was like, oh, we were all willing to go. I was like, no, you really weren't. Because, like, I was trying to pad the numbers with people I thought would enjoy it. And then, like... I just realized that half the people I was inviting were people that didn't know the other half of people,
mm-hmm.
like, very well, and probably wouldn't have gotten along with them very well.
Yeah, that could kind of be.
And that was a real issue, but now that I know more people, I'm probably going to be able to see if I can get something like that together again.
How do I get up here? Can I try this? Let's see.
Home!
No, that doesn't work.
Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Bring it back now, y'all. cha cha, real smooth. Do you guys, okay, do you guys have like a theme song from a TV show you watched as kids that's like instantly recognizable and you just immediately know that the show, what the show is by the sound of it, and that you immediately associate it with happy times watching it?
I think we kind of like unanimously agree on that with Power Rangers.
Well, besides Power Rangers, because, you know, Power Rangers, but individually, did you guys have like that one show, like as soon as you heard the theme song, you're like, ah, yeah, it's my jam.
No, so Dragon Ball?
It was...
Okay.
Well, I didn't grow up with Dragon Ball.
Neither did I, really.
Yeah, I don't know, Ninja Turtles, so, Batman, X-Men, all those themes.
The
songs.
Batman animated series theme?
Yeah.
Oh, it's so badass. You want to know what my
Elfman?
Danny, oh yeah, it is by Danny Elfman. Yeah, oh my god. Okay, you know what one of my top five is? Mm. The Thomas the Tank Engine theme.
I don't even remember how
that
goes.
Dun dun
dun dun dun. Oh yeah.
They incorporated train sounds into it, which I thought was super cool.
There's an arrow going through this chest.
I did not watch Thomas. I was past the age for Thomas.
No.
But you know what I did like best about Thomas was that George Carlin was the conductor.
Oh, yeah. And he even referenced that in one of his stand-up bits. He's like, you know why I have to watch...
This is Mr. Conductor talking. I know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, it's exactly what he says. Yeah. I thought it was cool when they got Ringo Starr to play Mr. Conductor in the first season.
Oh, really? Oh, I didn't even know that.
Yeah, it was cool. He had, like, his earring and everything. Like his Howie Mandel jewelry and all that.
Why was he only on for one season?
Well, because when the show originally aired in Britain, they had to have an actor who could narrate the things very well. So they just decided to get a celebrity from Britain that was famous enough. So they just hired Ringo Starr. And then when they started bringing the show here to America, they decided to have like kind of a television show that displayed and showcased Thomas episodes. So what they did was they created this thing called Shining Time Station, which is just, childhood. It basically was an Americanized version of Thomas the Tank Engine that kind of had segments that were between episodes for Thomas. So, like, it all took place at, like, this, like, place called Shining Time Station, where, like, kids would be running around and talking to the station manager, Wendy, I think her name was. She was really cool. And then they would meet this guy called Mr. Conductor, who was played by Ringo Starr. And then later on, George Carlin took over.
Who remembers Ringo?
Nobody, not even Ringo.
look, everyone, Ringo wrote a song.
Let's put it right here, right on the fridge. I told that joke to my math tutor, and he thought it was the funniest thing he'd ever heard. He's like, what is that? And I'm like, it's from Family Guy.
Stop falling. Blink, 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 blink. Stop. Link, you're losing more ground than you're gaining, buddy.
When I was starting high school, Family Guy had just gotten back on air. They were doing their fourth season. I remember all my teachers thinking, like, I swear to God, Family Guy kills more brain cells for you kids than SpongeBob does.
And you're like, not the ratings, they're number one!
Well, I mean, I don't know. I actually learned about things from Family Guy and references.
I now get half the jokes because I'm an adult now,
yeah, exactly.
But whatever.
I've grown up with Family Guy since I was 10, 11.
I love how, like, I started off hating the show entirely.
Really?
And I did. Like, when I first watched it, I was like, this isn't funny at all. I don't get it. And then as I started going through high school, I watched it and I was like, oh, okay. I mean, I get some of the jokes they're saying because I started watching more television and movies by then. And then I was like, I'm still iffy on whether or not I like this or not. So then I started hanging out with you guys, and I was like, you know what? I'm okay with Family Guy's jokes. At least the ones we quote to each other.
I like Family Guy, at least. I really like the first three seasons, and then I think that is a strong comeback, and then I think everything starts...
I think after its fifth, from there. After its sixth season, it started getting, like, really bad.
Yeah, I think that's when things... I think all the writing and everything was getting really lazy at that point.
That's when Seth MacFarlane stopped writing for the show. Was the sixth season or so?
He was too busy trying to be a hero, working on that Cleveland show. And, you know,
he had almost
trying to get Ted going and all that. So.
I'm gonna give my full-on opinion of Seth MacFarlane, and I'm not holding anything back. Mm-hmm. I think he is a phenomenal performer and a creative genius. Mm-hmm. However, I think it was really dumb of him to try and do so many things with Family Guy, Cleveland Show, American Dad, and everything else.
He's got an ego, yeah.
Yeah. He's developed sort of an ego that's kind of ruined his reputation.
Yeah. Definitely.
And I feel like I see all the jokes he makes in Family Guy, and I'm like, how the hell does this guy have any friends whatsoever in the Hollywood universe? So, I have come up with this theory that he asks them for permission of whether or not he can make a joke on his show about them or referencing something. And even if they say yes or no, he still does it. But I don't know. Like I think he as a person is pretty cool. Because he sings. Like, he's had the same vocal coach as Bette Midler, Barbara Streisand, Frank Sinatra Jr., which is why Frank Sinatra Jr. is featured prominently on the show in one season.
But we're talking about his character and personality,
but
his
accomplishments are very vast, that's for sure. But it's undermined by his ability to actually be top-tier performance.
Yeah, like he likes to think of himself
that,
as
keys.
He's not.
I almost said, please. I'm not playing Battleborn.
But I think when he made a million ways to die in the West... Mm-hmm. Like,
yeah, that really solidified it.
That really solidified that he's just reaching way too far. But I did like the Back to the Future reference in the movie and Django's reference.
I can't even remember any jokes I left out in that movie.
The only thing I remember is when Neil Patrick Harris shits in a hat. And it's
probably right. That is the thing I remember most now that you
mention it. And the mustache song. The mustache song is so fucking funny in that song, in that movie.
Really? I don't remember laughing.
Oh, mustache! Oh, mustache! You won't get a girl if you have a mustache. Or something like that. I don't know.
Something like that.
That was...
I'm glad someone remembered.
And then Ted
it.
2 came out and nobody cared.
There was a Ted 2?
Yeah, there was a Ted 2.
If Mila Kunis wasn't in it, I don't give a shit.
I don't know if she was or not.
I don't think she was. I think she was, but at the same time, it's like, why?
Well, I just remember it came and went, because when Ted came out, it actually did really well box office wise, and it was in theaters for like.
Yeah, and then when Ted 2 came out, there was barely any hype for it.
Yeah, it was in the theater for like less than a week, and then it was out. So.
Yeah, my friend's like, "Oh, Ted 2 is at the Dollar Theater. Want to go see it?" And I'm like, "It belongs at the Dollar Theater."
It's like, no, I don't want to watch it. That just sounds really bad.
If I got my balls chopped off by a hooker cannibal, I'm pretty sure that would be a better time than seeing Ted 2 at the Dollar Theater.
There's barely enough plot for the first Ted movie. I didn't get how you can make a Ted 2.
I don't sound like Peter Griffin. What are you talking about?
That's about the only funny thing.
No, I thought the part when they had... The first part when when they get the guy that played Flash Gordon to do cocaine and he actually just goes nuts is probably one of the funniest parts of that movie.
All that stuff that goes on in that party scene is really funny.
Yeah,
there was like the Flash Gordon theme plays, and it's like, holy shit!
Mm-hmm. Unhealthy obsession with that movie, really.
I have never seen that, but I really have a desire to.
I don't know. After seeing it in that movie, I'm kind of like, I wonder if that was just
trying to remember the quote. It's like Mark Wahlberg comes in, he's like, "Ted, there's shit on the floor or something," and Ted's just like, "Or what if the floor is on the ship?" Something like that. Yeah. I laughed pretty hard at that.
I think it's so funny when the movie starts, they're like, he's like a kid and Ted's like a little baby, and like not a baby, but like he basically has like he talks like a kid. Mm-hmm. But then when they grow up, they both talk like full on adults, like with bad mouths.
Mm-hmm.
Potty mouths.
Well, I mean, that's why after the credit sequence you're up and see him smoking a bong. So
yeah,
and they're both watching SpongeBob.
Yeah. Yeah.
Very, very much like many early 20-year-olds today.
Yeah.
Yeah. Unfortunately.
What are you saying? I can't enjoy SpongeBob?
Is that what it sounds like to smoke?
No, this is what it sounds like for me to smoke. Ow. Ow, fuck.
Smokey the Bear.
Only you can take a hit. He holds out a joint. You see this shit? This shit ain't cool.
See this? This is crack. Rock cocaine. This is cool for kids stuff.
Fucking lizard guys.
What?
It's when Pee Wee Herman does his drug
test.
Remember? He's talking about crack.
And what was the whole thing?
It's up here.
This
here
is
go.
Crack. Rock cocaine. Is glamorous or cool for kids stuff? Look, we all want to be cool. But doing crack isn't just wrong. It could be dead wrong.
Oh my god. I still think my favorite drug PSA is like, this is your brain. This is your brain on drugs.
See, the first one of that isn't too bad, but then when they bring in the crazy lady who swings the frying pan everywhere and hits everything and she just goes the fuck off.
I think the robot chicken version of that is pretty funny. She's like standing on top of the building, there's cops underneath, and she's like, this is what happens to family values! This is what happens to education! And then she knocks Any herself questions? Out with a frying pan.
Any questions?
Ding!
Yeah. I like it when she takes the puppy and she just hits it with the
frying pan.
You know which ones I thought were really ridiculous? When it would show, like, okay, in the beginning the girl's like perfectly healthy or whatever.
Uh-huh.
And then after she takes a hit, like the next time they see her, she's like a deflated mess on the couch.
Oh,
like,
yeah, those are
like,
weird.
I'm like, really?
Oh, yeah, I hate that one.
What even?
Those I've stopped seeing drug PSAs.
Oh, hey, this is like an actual.
I don't think our world cares anymore.
You know, when I see them, I God, they're interesting, though, to say the least.
They're hilarious.
Yeah. This one that I saw, it's not that old, it's like less than a couple of years old. But yeah, like this girl's hanging out at a party and someone comes up to her, hey, you want to try meth? And she agrees to it. And she's like, okay, here's your meth money, and here's your meth friends,
and here's your
meth boyfriend.
Here's your meth baby.
Yeah, your meth baby.
You know, one of my other favorite drug PSAs is the one where there's a dog just sitting outside, and it's like, Rocky, and he's got like a cigarette in his paws.
Oh,
and he's
yeah,
just
the
like,
animated one. Yeah.
He's like, I'm a dog. What's your excuse? What the fuck?
I love when they did that on Family Guy.
Yeah.
We should make a drug PSA with FNAF awesome. Characters.
Totally should.
Oh my god.
This is your brain. This is your brain on electricity.
I don't remember the exact PSA, but one of the dumbest things I ever heard, one of them was 50% of inner city kids smoke marijuana.
What?
Where do you think the other half get it from?
That's pretty trippy.
The what?
Yeah, that's what I was like, what the fuck does that mean? No joke.
Sure hope I need that, because that seems like it's gonna be important.
I work
Puzzles
hard.
Are weird.
So I can earn more, so I can do more coke. So I can work longer. So I can earn more. So I can do more coke.
What the hell?
It's another drug PSA.
There was one PSA that I remember very funny. Like, to be very funny, this guy's in the doctor's office, and he's, like, he's coughing, and he looks just really, like, worn out and like, sick. Mm-hmm. And it's just, like, make sure you check your home before you buy it. It might have been a former meth lab. And I'm like, what the fuck? Apparently the residual... Like, the residual chemicals of the meth lab were left in the house.
Right.
And, like, the smell just got to the owners who owned it. And this guy's just sitting there, he's like... and it's just like,
cool.
Make sure the meth lab... Make sure your house wasn't a former meth lab. I'm like, how the fuck are you not certain of that?
Right, so for your new property...
Nobody told me.
For your new property, you could choose between the house of homicide or the mansion of meth.
The mansion of meth? You mean the Playboy mansion?
The meth lab mansion.
The meth lab mansion. It's like Jeez. The new video game.
Luigi will be exploring that.
Oh! Mario!
Oh, God.
Oh, man,
oh,
that's scary.
Well, hello,
Emma's. He's just like running through the house with a vacuum. He looks at the vacuum and he's like.
I need to do that back from the beginning now. I'm gonna hate myself if I do. Okay, put me right. Okay.
Stand on the tesseract.
Oh, you know what? Okay, I know how to do this.
Do you know?
Watch this. You know what? I did that wrong. I need to step on the platform first. Well, I'm dumb. Wait for this platform to go up. Then watch. I'm gonna show you some shit.
Ah, it smells!
Right, it does.
A fartsicle. Farts you can lick. Put it in your face mouth.
It's cold and it smells. God, how did you make that so fast?
It's one of my favorite Parks and Rec moments.
Oh, okay.
Like, she's on the radio, and she's on, like, the show with Crazy Ira and the Douche, and they're, like those chatterhead radio jockeys that basically are, like, the most obnoxiously annoying guys ever. Mm-hmm. And it's just like, yeah, I don't give a fartsicle. And it's just like, what's a fartsicle? Fartsicles. Farts you can eat. The frozen treat. Put it in your face mouth. And all of a sudden, like, the sound DJ is just, like, plays a clip that's like, it's cold and it smells. And then Leslie's like, God, how did you make that so fast? Oh, that show's amazing. I love it.
I know, you really like Parks and Rec.
It's one of my top five favorite sitcoms. That, Big Bang Theory, and Holocaust movies.
Actually, there is one
sitcom. I'm just kidding, I'm so sorry.
There is one sitcom you and I do unanimously agree on that we do really like, and that is Fraser.
Fraser is so freaking hilarious. I love that.
Yeah. See, I like, but that's because Fraser's smart.
Oh, it's so smart. Okay, you know the guy at my work who hates everything I love?
Does he actually like Fraser?
He hates Fraser.
Oh, really?
He's like, it's not funny. And I'm like, that's because you're an idiot.
Oh, hey, I got a headpiece.
Oh, cool. Yeah, he's like, I don't like it. It's not funny. And I'm like, because you don't get it.
I'm now Link, King of the Pirates.
Yo ho ho.
Because that's because growing up, you know, I didn't really watch a whole lot of TV, but my parents didn't really exactly let me either. But they only watched like two sitcoms, and one of those was Frasier, and the other one at the time was Just Shoot Me with David Spade.
Oh, sorry. Do you want me to do what?
Have you ever watched that?
No, I've never watched that, actually.
And the Drew Carey Show, which was also really popular.
Oh, it was great.
That's pretty funny.
I think it's that, okay, that and Whose Line Is It Anyway were his two greatest triumphs.
Yeah, you watch those back to back, exactly.
Oh, and then, like, in Whose Line Is It Anyway, Ryan would be like, give the tall guy more lines.
Yeah.
One of my favorite Frasier.
Welcome back to the 24-hour Drew Carey Network.
What was it? Charities you don't think you should donate money to. Get Drew Carey a third show. There's one Frasier episode that I thought was really funny is where Niles and Frasier decide to write a book together about the like psychology and its different studies and all that, mm-hmm. and they coop themselves up in a hotel room to focus on writing, and it just devolves into them just going at each other verbally and then physically. So there's a scene where Frasier just like climbs on top of Niles and is strangling him by his shirt collar, and then Niles is like, "Oh God, I'm having flashbacks to when I was in seventh grade, or to when I was 6 years old," and then Frasier's like, "You stole my mommy!" It's so fucking funny. It's like, oh, Niles, oh, my back, oh, and then Niles is like, oh, Fraser, are you okay? He's like, I can't believe you fell for that! And he just leaps onto him. Oh, I love that show.
Yes, Link with his pirate hat.
I think Niles was one of the best parts of that show.
Someone on Facebook I saw really recently with Fraser, and it's like, the dog who played Eddie, he thought all of that was real.
Really?
Yeah, no, but that was the joke, because he's a dog, he doesn't know television's television. So
no,
he thought he was with a real family.
The trainer they got for those two dogs was so good at her job.
Oh, yeah?
Like they that's why I praise certain movies with good dog training.
Yeah,
Like, The Grinch has a perfect dog trainer that they had. Like, I've never seen a dog react so well to scenes happening in a movie. Mm-hmm. Because there are some animals that get stage fright and they can't perform well, but, like, I think the trainers they've had for, like, Fraser and the Grinch movie were, like, two of the greatest worked ones ever, but I think it's sad that they don't get enough credit for their job. I just think any moment with Fraser and Eddie is, like, the best part of Fraser.
Yeah, no, he really does. He kind of steals the show when comes on.
And he's like, I suppose you have something to rebuttal with? And then all of a sudden Eddie just runs out and he's like, that's what I thought! There was one that I thought was really funny where, like, Fraser was in such a good mood and he's just like, well, Eddie, you want a staring contest? Well, not today, boyo! And he, like, looks him directly in the eyes and then Eddie just runs off.
God.
I always thought Martin was funny.
So much
their dad.
Damage.
Yeah, their dad.
Their dad is so funny.
Okay.
I'm Marty Crane. Crime is painful. If you don't think that's true, look at this. And he pulls down his like pants to show him his butt scar from his bullet wound. And Fraser and Niles are like, oh, God!
So, Well, how many people in our audience have actually watched Fraser? Because I haven't.
Because so I know we're spending so much time talking about it.
So I don't know what they're talking about.
I'm sorry. Honestly. I feel like we shouldn't be alienating you. I feel...
I was expecting to get on a Fraser rant.
Yeah, I don't know Fraser.
I think you would like it.
At all.
Honestly,
you
I think...
You probably would. Yeah.
You like intellectual jokes, so I'm pretty sure you'd find
oh,
it funny.
Shit.
Whoa!
Well,
it's come off of us not talking about the game to us now focused on the game.
Yeah, so I got through that trial, got this nice hat, and now I'm trying to find Kakariko Village. Get the fuck away from me.
Stop Michael Baying the enemies. Though, speaking about Michael Bay, who wants to talk about Transformers?
No.
I do! You know I do.
No, God, no.
The one that's coming up is his last movie.
There we go. No, you did that in the Borderlands video.
What, talking about that?
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry.
Jeez, trying to play Zelda. A lot of people haven't seen this game yet.
I'm sorry, I feel like we're making you very mad. Are we?
I don't care, talk about whatever you want.
No, but... I don't want to upset you.
He's right, we should talk about Zelda.
All I want to say is I'm very excited for the new Transformers movie. All I'm going to say. Next topic. Yeah, Zelda looks cool.
Best segue yet.
I have a segue, and it's specifically from getting to point A to point B.
I hate it.
Link was once a pirate. Speaking of pirates.
Yes, he was.
Pirates Link's of the Caribbean 5 looks awesome. It actually does. It looks like a pretty great movie.
Indeed.
Mm-hmm.
I showed you the trailer for that, right?
Yeah, you did.
Yeah, it looks pretty good. I like that shot where he's, like, on the ground, and it's, like, he's, like, slowly falling forward, and he's, like, holding, like, his drink as he's falling on the ground, and, like, he's not rolling, he's just sliding across the ground as it's tilting. I just love that shot. It's really funny.
What can I cook with a quesai, a mushroom, and a snail?
Flame-roasted toast.
That's gonna be something gross.
Oh. No.
Dubious food.
I love how it's blurred
it's
out.
To even look at.
It puts issues forth in your stomach region.
Yeah. That's wrong.
When you can hear
it
your
gives
stomach...
gives you 5 health, but then takes away 5 health.
Yeah, exactly.
It so gives you 5 health, but takes away 100 health.
It's because he eats it, and he's happy to eat it first, but then he vomits, and that causes more damage.
Oh,
God. If you have projectile vomiting in a game, it kills you. I really would like that to be a gameplay mechanic for some reason.
In Conker's Bad Fur Day, urine was actually a weapon at a couple points in the game. We had to urinate on enemies. Or use your...
It's possible to make Snake throw up and Snake eat her.
That is true,
yes.
If you
eat bad food.
If you eat, expired food.
What Snake Eater?
Metal Gear Solid.
One of the best Metal Gear Solid games ever.
What was that one game we played at your house game, James, that, it had Michael Bane, but he had, like, a cyborg arm or something.
That was,
Was that Mad World?
No, that was Blood Dragon.
Blood Dragon.
Blood Dragon,
Far Cry
3.
I liked that game.
Blood Dragon's awesome.
I really want to play more of it.
Yeah.
Next time we hang out at your house, we're playing it. It's a date.
It's just making decisions without his consent. But yeah, sure, we can... Do that at any time. No.
Well, he has my Steam account, so he can play Blood Dragon whenever he wants.
Can I?
Yeah.
You don't even know if it'll work.
I'm gonna try it, damn it.
So we installed Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Mm. God, we're going on a tangent. Installed Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 on his computer and found out the game can only run flawlessly if it's at a resolution of 640 by, like, 480.
That's weird.
So... Well, I mean, it's not that weird because he doesn't have a dedicated graphics card.
Yeah.
The game runs flawlessly, which is funny, but it's just so weird.
So it's like the same resolution we were playing MVC 2 earlier.
Yeah, pretty much. The difference is... Whoa, what the shit is that?
That's a paper dragon.
My New Year's resolution is 800 by 600.
What?
Isn't it your New Year's resolution?
Get it?
No.
Kind of scared.
Oh, I see.
Kind of scared to touch these
pretty
spikes.
Basic.
Yep, knew I shouldn't have.
My mother took my keys because she saw me talking to a woman at the supermarket. She was right to do it.
I think I know how to get.
You know what I'm quoting, right?
No, I don't actually.
Principal Skinner from Simpsons.
Simpsons.
Mother, I can't fit into that sailor suit anymore. I'm an adult.
Too bad.
Seymour! Are you and your friends playing WoW?
WoW?
Well.
Oh. Are you playing WoW? Yes, Mother!
Yes, Mother!
I started a night elf.
Hi, Super Nintendo Chalmers.
Hi, Super Nintendo Chalmers. Super Nintendo Chalmers, I threw up in your bag. I got carsick in your office. That's what it was.
I'm in danger.
My tummy has a headache.
Ralph is the best.
Ralph is one of the best characters in The Simpsons.
Wow, this meatloaf tastes like grandma. You're right. Ralphie, it does taste like grandma.
Ah, you're right. It does taste like grandma.
Gosh.
I think it's funny how both Ralph and Chief Wiggum kind of are stupid.
Well, they're obviously the stupidest characters.
My friend, okay, you guys might get your minds blown by this, but my friend has a theory that Policeman Eddie is Ralph's real father.
Oh. Because
they have the same hair.
Mm-hmm.
And my friend actually thought of this entire episode idea where that actually comes to light,
mm-hmm.
where, like, Eddie reveals that he's Ralph's father.
Mm-hmm. And you can do it on the walls. That's
cool. Whoa, shit. Anyway, so he thought of this whole, like, episode.
Okay, Link. If you don't want to grab that, that's perfectly fine.
But he planned it out so well that it actually made really, like, very good sense.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, you almost should write that and submit it to
Link.
Link's taking lessons from the School of Uncharted and not grabbing things.
Fucking Nick.
Yeah, I don't get. What? Did you just say the N-word?
No, I said Nick. I was trying to think of the name of the guy who's from Uncharted. But I might be
thinking. That's Nathan. Not his name.
No.
Nathan.
I would never say that word on the show. I hope you know that. I would never, in my entire career as a YouTube artist, which has been in the past 4 months, I would never.
Has it been 4 months?
It has, because did we start late November?
No, I don't think it was planned.
No, we started in December, I'm pretty sure.
December, okay,
yeah.
So December, January, February, March. It's been almost 5 months.
Jeez.
That makes you think. Yeah, in my entire career as a YouTube artist, I would never in my entire time ever say that word. Televised, at least. At home, though. I'm just kidding. No, I don't believe in using that word for any sense. It's too offensive, and I don't know very many black people who would probably take that well if someone of my color said it. So.
Anyway.
Uh-huh.
Have you seen that one interview that that Samuel L. Jackson did where, like, when he was promoting Django Unchained,
mm-hmm.
and they wanted him to say, like he was trying to get the newscaster guy to say the N-word.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, it's not going to be offensive to me if you say it. And the guy's like, I'm sorry, I just flat out don't want to say it.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, then I refuse to answer any more questions you have if you don't say it.
Really?
And it's like,
wow.
That's kind of a bold move.
Yeah, not really.
These puzzles are a little tricky. I like it. Get in the hole, please.
Don't.
Come on. Do we get tickets if you do?
I was just gonna say that.
A bunch of tickets, just like disperse.
Oh, 500,000 tickets. So this will probably get me. I don't know, a whistle.
A bouncing ball. You have 280. I don't know. Felt like we spent more than 280 tickets worth of time.
It's such a weird economy system they have there.
And nickel.
Yeah.
Doesn't make any sense. I like how for most of the games they have tickets like labeled over what the original thing was.
Right. I like that most of the games we played there were Japanese machines and them were American manufactured.
Oh, that poor Marvel 2 cabinet.
Yeah.
That thing needs some love.
Probably
I
by
kid
us.
You not. I don't think the first player controls were like all working.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised with how you played, yeah.
I couldn't sprint.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't figure out how to do hyper combos. It felt like a lot of moves. Just, like, when I was facing you,
mm-hmm.
and I did, like, a quarter circle forward,
mm-hmm.
or, like, a hadoken, or a hurricane kick. It came out fine when I was on your side of the screen facing to the left. I couldn't do it.
Mm.
It wouldn't register that I was doing the move. So I don't know.
Huh.
Well, that's what happens. That's arcade, guys. People need to take better care of their cabinets.
Well, that's the thing is there used to be a whole maintenance guy that would come and fix them. Like, they'd actually have someone.
I'm sure they still have it.
But the thing is it's such a dying media that, it's so hard to get that kind of gig.
Normal-ass guy over
so, like,
here.
When something of that era finally dies out or just stops working, there's no way to repair it or replace it.
Well, yeah.
Because they don't manufacture them as much anymore.
And it's especially a problem now because people aren't making CRT monitors anymore.
Yeah.
Old glass monitors, and unfortunately, that's the majority of our arcade games are played on those.
Yeah. So.
Think about it, though. 20 years ago, an arcade mechanic or an arcade maintenance guy would have probably been the coolest job ever.
Yeah, right?
For someone like us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're not that complicated. I mean, they're just basically a big circuit board for the most part. That's what
Yeah. And, now it's just the people who work at Nickel that just take a hammer out and smack it.
Yeah.
It's like... And then I think it's also funny that when the ticket thing jams, they just open it and then just... pull a whole roll out and just say, okay, you get 17 tickets. It's like, but I won 300. And it's like, how do I know for sure you're not lying to me? And it's just like, look at my face. Do I look like I'm lying to you?
I like that after they get our tickets, they just throw them in a trash can. And I'm like, we should go find that trash bag and then come in with that.
Yeah.
Just wait outside their building when they finally close up for the night.
Exactly, yeah.
Jeez.
No, I think they recycle them because those paper look easily recyclable. Is that the Ocarina
of
Time
theme? That's Epona's theme.
Oh.
I was gonna say anyways, that. I think that's going to do it for this episode, guys. It's a little bit longer than usual, but we were having a lot of conversation. So,
most of it not related to Zelda.
As usual, feel free to follow us on Twitter at YouTube RGB or follow us on Facebook at Royal Gaming Battalion. My name is Joey, I'm joined by Jack and James, and we will see you all on the next episode of Breath of the Wild.
Oi!
Oi!
Till next time!
Welcome back to Breath of the Wild!
Oh boy!
Oh my! Bye bye!